Beethoven, Mozart, Larkin, Browns have all died.
Spares, aren't they?
Really? Oh, what are you saying, sir?
Wonderful people.
Are they?
Oh, yes, they really turn us on.
What do they do?
Well, suppose they turn other people on.
That's just their tough trick.
It's what?
Nothing, a rude word. Next question.
No, no. What was the rude word? Was it really? Good heavens, you frightened me to death.
Oh, all right.
What about you girls behind?
I thought you're dead, isn't he, this geezer?
Are you,
Actually, I was surprised that Johnny didn't make any comment about this record because very early in the Sex Pistols' career, he delivered the same kind of thing.
Yes, 4 years ago. Big
yes,
difference.
That's fine. Four years ago, that's fine, John. And I'm quite sure that you're very proud of what you did 4 years ago. And I'm sure that these boys are equally as proud as what they've done here in 1979. So you can't criticise them from that particular angle. I think
I don't
like
to be patronised, and that's what that record reads.
Shut
so.
Up, will you?
No, I will not.
I think one of the great pities on this particular record.
It's rubbish. Full stop. Rubbish. Miss.
How would you like a nice smack in the head?
Not very much.
Well, then shut your mouth and get out of my way with that thing.
What do you think you can offer a 16-year-old Green Day fan that Green Day can't?
Big Willie. MTV? Bye-bye. I think I said my piece.
Yeah.
Off!
With the Look, street. I don't have to explain myself to anybody and I ain't going to really bother. Now, I was asked here, right, to interview with the band here, Pill, but now, like, we're facing a cheapskate comedy interrogation act and it just ain't on, pal. It's a joke. It's a farce.
You mean you don't want to give any messages to
I don't have to explain myself. Sooner or later, somebody will open their eyes. Oh, sorry, rude word.
Well, it sounds like we've heard this story before.
Really? Would you like to tell me where? Good night.
Now, Mr. Wilson,
there's no point in me wasting money on separate individual hotel rooms when I'm perfectly able to share.
Mr.
And I'm
Leiden.
Apparently the pop star.
Mr. Leiden.
Don't be disrespectful, sir. I haven't disrespected you, have I?
No, you haven't.
Okay. So let's not be disrespectful.
Apologies.
In my home. Okay.
You were talking about making a film where you kill famous people. Now, this has never been played on television before, but it has a particular relevance. Let's listen to this.
I'd like to kill Jimmy Savile. I think he's a hypocrite.
Weren't I right?
I bet he's into all kinds of seediness. That we all know about, but we're not allowed to talk about. I know some rumours. I bet none of this will be allowed out.
I shouldn't imagine libelous stuff will be allowed out.
Nothing I said is libel.
We wrote the songs, we did all the work, we did the gigs, we led the lifestyle, and he just seemed to have collected the accolades, which... well, for a certain point as well, he tried to collect the money as well. But I fought that court case and won, on everyone's behalf.
Look, everything half-eaten, I see Roseanne's been here. Is that supposed to be her?
That is her.
Vile hands. I'm not going to be rowing with her. I have this agreement in front of me,
right,
saying I can film backstage. This is backstage. What would you like me to hold on to? Another camera? Now you're telling me I have no access?
Exactly. You've broken the rules and you're...
And what rules would those be, Mrs? Because I have it clearly written here. You are contradicting your own agreement.
Oh, we're no longer on the show. Look. I am now being removed from the Roseanne Barr show.
I wanted to talk to Ozzy Osbourne. You've done such great stuff over the years, starting with Black Sabbath. You know, you're a working class Englishman here. But he can't be bothered to turn up. Courtney Love Kurt's money.
Kill me.
With your wonderful excuse, I'm making a film. You love the idea of being a rebel, but you haven't proved to me or anybody exactly what being a rebel is. What are you rebelling against? You're just a pile of confusion. Axl Rose. His mediocre excuse at the moment is that he's in studio recording. This is a man who also at the same time proclaims that he loves my singing style. You're a fraud. And I'm underwhelmed.